In this video, I'll show you how to permanently add subtitles to a video or movie using Wondershare UniConverter 13. Welcome to this video. My name is David, and I hope you're well. You need two things. You need the video, and you need the subtitle that you want to add to the video. So if you cannot see the subtitle editor, then you need to either click on this particular functionality here to see the subtitle editor, or you can just click on the toolbox so that you see what's available. The subtitle editor is a new feature in Wondershare UniConverter 13. So that's what we need. So let's just click on that. And from this particular option, you can see information retrieval field, please check your internet connection. This is the free version of Wondershare. It gives you, I think it's one free trial. So that's what I want to try it out, so that if you wanted to make a purchase to use Wondershare UniConverter to add subtitles to a video, then you know what you're going into. So let's just click on add a video, and we just click on that. And then let's just add this particular video because I have subtitles for this video. Just click on open. By With default, once you add a video to the subtitle editor, it starts playing automatically. Now you can just pause it. You can mute it from this particular section just by clicking on that. You can expand it to see the whole video. Press escape to get out of that view. But below here, you have the option to add a new subtitle, and this you will have to actually type in the content on this particular section. You also have the option to import. You also have the option to use the auto subtitle generator, which is still in beta. And if you click on this particular option, it's going to let you know that you need to upgrade to subtitle editor subscription plans, that you can actually use it. But let's just close because we don't want to test that. And you'll see if you have added a subtitle, and there's no subtitle at the moment, and you can add it, but we're going to use this option. And then once you're done, where your file is actually going to go, on the right is where we are going to be making any edits we need to make to the subtitle. So let's begin by clicking on import. And I have a bunch of subtitles here, but let's just navigate and pick this one. It's the English version, and by default it's auto-populates here. I wish it was possible to actually maximize this particular window so that we can see what you're working on. Now, since there's no subtitle that has been selected, if I click on the first subtitle, it's going to be active on this side, and you can make any edits that you want on that subtitle from here. So let's say we make changes to this one subtitle. So we can do that. Let's say we want to change this size to about 25. Let's make it smaller. And since it's not easily legible, let's just change the color of the subtitle to yellow. It has a small outline width and it's bold. We can undo the bold. If you wanted to underline, which I've never seen in subtitles, you can. But let's just add a width of about 4. But everything is a little bit clearer. So that looks good. But one thing that you need to note is that when you make edits to one subtitle, they don't affect the other subtitles. So once you make edits to one particular subtitle that is in here, that is a block of subtitle, then you'll need to click on apply all these particular changes you've made so that they apply to everything. But one thing that I love about Wondershare's UniConverter subtitle editor is that let's assume we actually click on apply all. Yes. So we've applied all the edits and the settings we've made for the first subtitle to everything else. But let's say we wanted this one subtitle to be at the position at the top. So we can just change that. And if we move to the next one, it's still down here. So that is one good thing about this particular option. Let's say we also wanted to change this one to move up. It moves up. So we can see this is up, down, 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 up. Therefore, you can easily avoid any lower third graphics inside Wondershare's UniConverter subtitle editor, which is a plus. I wish they added the option to import and export subtitles in Wondershare Filmora 10 or even 11. My assumption is that that is coming, but I wish they did that. That's the only missing ingredient in Filmora 10. So once you're done with your subtitles and all that, all you need to do is just press on the button to export. If I click on this, then it tells me you can only edit one file in the trial version. Upgrade to premium for unlimited features. That's okay. Let's just say we just want to try this. Continue trial. Video exporting. So I just want to see if the result is something worth somebody making a purchase or even getting the paid plan. So if you're interested in banning subtitles where you can make the different edits that you want, then Wondershare UniConverter is a good option. So we can just see what we did here. Let's right click on the video and open it using, let's say open with VLC media player. So let's just play it.
With the recent update on the YouTube interface,
we can see that the subtitles are playing. And this one, we set it to be up there.
Than before to download
the others down here.
Transcripts. Hi, my name is David from freelancerinsights.com, where we believe you should never stop learning. This video.
And then the other one goes up there. So it's done a pretty good job. And that is the power in Wondershare UniConverter, where the subtitle editor allows you to make all the changes that you want to the subtitles as a whole. That is, if you make any changes to just one subtitle here, let's assume this one, you make all the changes, you can apply to all or just leave the changes to that. You can have this in a different color, whatever you want, but the others to be in different colors, set up different positions, etc. So if that's your thing, then Wondershare UniConverter, you should consider getting Wondershare UniConverter, and you can check out the links below to get Wondershare UniConverter. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope that you find what you're looking for when it comes to banning subtitles. Thanks for watching. My name is David. Until next time, stay safe and never stop learning. Thanks for watching.